eyes and I'm saying, okay, where is the talent? If you're telling me that Andrew Wiggins is that guy, then I'm like, okay, nah, that's not good enough. Remember, they tried to sit there and say that Andrew Wiggins was a next LeBron James. And I'm like, huh? What? And then I saw him playing the NCAA tournament. Like I said before, I saw him playing the NCAA tournament and I'm like, what is special? See, what college does is it allows you, number one, to get mature. That's number one, because we see what happens when you have a youngster in the NBA in regards to D'Angelo Russell. You do stupid stuff, right? It allows you to do that. It allows you to get stronger. And then the most important part of all, it allows you to be like Michael Jordan and to really work on your game. And on top of that, it allows you to actually win. You want guys who can be able to win. Magic Johnson was a winner when he was in college. Michael Jordan was a winner when he was in college. And that translated to the NBA. Now, I'm not sitting here saying that you have to win in college in order to be a great player. If that be the case, then Christian Laettler and Bobby Hurley, those guys would have been something special. I'm not saying that. What I am saying is that you either want to see somebody dominate, or you want to see somebody dominate and then win the championship, like those two great players that I just mentioned. Look at Tim Duncan, greatest power forward ever. Guess what? He spent, was it 4 years in college? So if I'm picking my top five greatest players of all time, oh, and Doug Stewart, I got to get after you. You said LeBron James was in your top five. Doug Stewart, I don't know what you're talking about. So you just going to sit there, you just going to disrespect Shaq. I understand that it's your list. I get that. But then your list is wrong. Because LeBron James, yes, he won his championship 3-1 against a team that has absolutely no post play. Absolutely none whatsoever. So, okay, yeah, you beat them. You shouldn't even got down 3-1. Okay, whatever. But then you got Shaq Diesel. And you just pretty much said, forget you, Shaq. I don't care about your 4 championships. I don't care about the fact that you won 3 in a row and sit there and dominate far more superior teams. You just sit there and you just disregard that. You're just going to sit there and disrespect Shaq Diesel to elevate LeBron James. Once again, we have these people that is on that bandwagon. They need to sit there and put everything into its proper perspective. Let's do that. And see, and it's like, and one thing I will say about Doug, and one of the main reasons why I do listen to his show is that he thinks like me. When I listen to a lot of these other guys that talk sports on out here in LA, 570, Fox and ESPN 710, they pretty much say what the ninja always says. The you know, you want to follow mainstream narrative. That's one of the main reasons why I listen to Doug, because he thinks like me. Even though he wasn't thinking like I would be thinking, talking about LeBron James is in his top five, and then you just going to sit there and disrespect Big Shaq Diesel. Come on now. Nah, that's not going to even fly with me. And then also he did it playing against far more superior teams. LeBron James had a cakewalk to the NBA Finals. Mind you, they went up against the Miami Heat. They went up against Lance Stephenson in the Pacers with Roy Hibbert. Come on. That's who they went up against in the Eastern Conference Finals. It's always easy. But then when he has lost, he has looked bad. So, no, you're not going to sell me on that one. But yeah, let me get back to the top five because I'm still on the draft and I'm going to get off of it in a moment. But I want you to understand this. So if we're looking at the top five, Larry Bird, 4 years. I think he actually stopped going because he actually went to Indiana. He stopped going to Indiana and then he went back to school and then went to Indiana State. So Larry Bird is still, for me, better than LeBron James. I'm going to go with Larry Bird. I'm going to do that. Why Larry Bird didn't have to sit there and leave this town and play with this guy and then do this. Nah, he didn't have to do that. So I'm still going to put Larry Bird there. LeBron James got to win another championship to surpass Larry Bird. So I'm going to go with Larry Bird. Then Magic. He did more than a year at Michigan State. I just finished lamenting Michael Jordan, Tim Duncan, and I'm going to go with Shaq because of just sheer dominance. To me, the greatest player is Kareem Abdul-Jabbar. He still did more than a year at UCLA. So when you look at my top five, these guys were well-seasoned players in college. You look at these little bums that's coming into the NBA. They're killing my game. There's no fluidity. There's no fundamentals. It's awful. And they're costing GMs their jobs. And that's just not cool. Whew. Okay, that was a good one. I love talking about, you know, the NBA and bestowing some knowledge on, you know, people out there who really don't, you know too much, or I have to show you a different light. So I want to switch over to the NFL, Matthew Stafford, and I'll talk about that next here on the Grizz. We're back, and this is The Grizz. Thank you for tuning in to me on SME. I truly, truly do. Who do I want to think out there? Grego, that's my guy. Grego, you know I got mad love for you, bro. You're always listening to my show, man. Grego, he's a cool dude. And there's somebody else who is it's a lady on there. I can't think of her name, but she's like brown skin. She's kind of thick. I don't want to be disrespectful, but I can't remember her name. She listens to the show. Thank you for listening to my show. And I apologize for not remembering the name. Matthew Stafford thinks that Lions will be tougher for defenses without Calvin Johnson. He needs to be drug tested. Seriously. We're talking about the same guy who would throw to Calvin Johnson, and there was like four or five guys on him. It's like, okay, dude, what are you doing? And then if he wasn't throwing to Calvin Johnson, then he was throwing interceptions. He had Calvin Johnson and still couldn't make the postseason. Still was, I don't want to say mediocre, but he was like a step away from being mediocre. I don't know what he's talking about. Seriously, I don't know what he's talking about. I don't see the Detroit Lions kicking up absolutely no type of dust, because why? They have Matthew Stafford. Matthew Stafford is a guy who got a ton of money. For what reason? I have no idea. Oh, I know why. Because, quote unquote, the NFL is a quarterback-driven league. Yes, it is, but that doesn't necessarily mean that you have to give a guy franchise quarterback type money. No, you don't have to do that. I mentioned on this show all the time that there's so many teams who have won championships with like above average quarterbacks or a quarterback who gets lucky. Like I said before, Joe Gibbs won 3 Super Bowls with 3 different quarterbacks. Bill Parcells, he won 2 Super Bowls with 2 different quarterbacks. It happens. So you don't need, hold on. The Baltimore Ravens won a Super Bowl with Trent Dilfer. Think about that, with Trent Dilfer. You don't have to have a franchise type quarterback and give him a whole bunch of money and then sit there and take away from different aspects of your team. You don't have to do that. That's what the Lions have done, and we're going to see how bad of a football player Matthew Stafford is. I don't believe he's going to do anything without Calvin Johnson. That's just my personal opinion. The Jets, you know what? I find the Jets very fascinating. This whole squabble with them and Ryan Fitzpatrick. Ryan Fitzpatrick doesn't want a 3-year, $24 million contract. He feels that it's far below his worth. Like I said before, this guy is a bum. Now he's a straight bum. He's a bum. This guy has never went to the postseason a day in his life. And he's talking about that's not enough money. How is that not enough money when you're a bum? Like he's a bum. Like, he's almost on Colin Kaepernick's level. As a matter of fact, he's a greeter at Walmart. Yeah, I said it. Join the Colin Kaepernick fan club. You need to be right next to Colin Kaepernick, right next to him, somewhere in the same vicinity as Colin Kaepernick, and he's a greeter for Walmart. He needs to go and fill out an application for Walmart, because I don't believe this guy. Who does this guy think he is? What has he done? Has he even went to a postseason? He can't even go to the postseason. How? And I don't understand the Jets. If I'm a Jets fan, I'm like, dude, forget Ryan Fitzpatrick. What has he done? Like I said before, when it was a chance for them to clinch a playoff spot, he threw picks. What has he done? I don't get it. I just don't get it. Somebody please tell me. Hold on. Let me calm down. I want to calm down. So let me calm down for a second, okay? I don't understand it. How a guy who hasn't done anything, who has constantly shown you that he's a bum, and for whatever reason, you keep gawking after him. It's like, fellas, it's like you're with that girl, and she's pretty much showing you that she don't care nothing about you. She tells you that I'm gonna treat you like trash, and you gotta deal with it. How I know that, because a girl actually told me that before. She was treating me bad, and I was like, man, you ain't got to do that. And she was like, I'm going to keep on doing it. Either you can talk to me, or you don't have to talk to me. And I was like, damn, like it's like that? She's like, pretty much. So even though I wanted to talk to her, I had to, you know, take my pride and go somewhere else. So I don't understand the Jets. This dude has proven consistently that he's not worth anything, and they're constantly going behind him wanting more. I don't understand it. What else do I have in store today? Okay, special team coaches consulted as NFL seeks more safety when it comes to more safety precautions when it comes to the touchback. Mind you, the NFL moved it back or up from, was it the 20-yard line to the 25-yard line because they didn't want the collisions. My thing is, the NFL has to understand this. They have to really understand this. This is the NFL. This is what guys sign up to do. So they have to understand that people are going to get hurt. It's just like in boxing. Yeah, you try to make the sport safer with certain things that you have a line, but at the end of the day, guys are going to die in the ring. I know it's a sad thing to say. I know it is, but that's just the fact. I hear so many different guys dying in the ring. And it's like, yeah, it's sad, but this is the sport that you chose to participate in. The same thing like the NFL. This is the National Football League. Guys understand that, you know what, there's a chance that I can get seriously hurt. So, you know, I love the fact that, you know, they have sought, you know, after, you know, these special teams or these special team coaches to seek more safety precautions for, you know, the kickback and stuff like that. I get all that. But the kickoff, I love the kickoff, being honest with you. There's nothing better to watch the Super Bowl, to see that kickoff, and to see all